Good morning, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us on this presentation of Operator Fabric. On behalf of Alejandro and LFA, I'm happy to present Operator Fabric. My name is Floris van der Meulen. I'm a business analyst at Alejandro. And together with my colleague Jeroen Gommans, we will give you a presentation of how we use Operator Fabric within system operations. So, today's session will be about accelerating your transformation to system operations with Operator Fabric. The agenda for today is an introduction of Alejandro and how we use Operator Fabric within Alejandro. Then I'm going to talk a little bit of how you can contribute to Operator Fabric. We will have a demo and then we have a closing. So Alejandro is the largest DSO in the Netherlands. We've got about approximately 5.8 million customers. And we've got 90,000 kilometers of cable, which of low voltage have 49,000 and high voltage 39,000 kilometers of cable. And our reliability of our network is 99.9%. In the past, we, as Alejandro, were only focused on distribution of gas and energy. We had only consumption and no production, and gas played a significant role in the Netherlands. So all the households use gas. We have a low voltage grid, which is a small capacity, and an oversized grid. Looking at Alejandro present, we have production and consumption in the network, electrification of the economy, so looking at heating instead of gas using H2O, we have charge point operators in the network, which are providing energy, we have a phase out of gas, we have grid extensions due to the fact that there is a lot of wind and solar added to our network, which also comes into where we have a capacity management to handle. Based on that new movement of not only have production, but also not only have consumption, but also have production, we created a new department within Alejandro, which will monitor the grid and we'll do capacity management, a bit of system cyber grid security, and we're working together with the TSOs and DSO and energy market to one energy system. Then about Operator Fabric. What is Operator Fabric? Operator Fabric is an application, a user interface, and provides the right information to the right person at the right time, plus reducing the number of operator screens. So what we see in Alejandro, there are multiple screens in which operators use to handle their actions. And Operator Fabric, the meaning of Operator Fabric is to capture that all in one screen. So let me click on to open the screen. So here you find Camunda, where you can look at a business process and where user tasks are defined, and that information will be shown. In Operator Fabric, you will see I'm logged in because we use single sign-on. So I'm just logged in as a user where you can show this information. This is just in the test environment to show you how the concept is set up. So we have the card feed, we have archives where we can filter on those archives by tags, and tags you can, these are basically message settings, attributes where you can add attributes in the messages. And then if they're displayed in Operator Fabric, you can filter on them. It's also possible to integrate other applications within your operator screen. So Operator Fabric can also open other applications. So for example, we just added Operator GitHub now here, and it opens the Operator Fabric. You have the possibility to look at, you can filter on alarm, action, compliant information. So the severity of the events, you can also deselect them and filter on that. So we've looked at this now briefly. And I would like to give the word to my colleague Jeroen, who can give a live demo, which is nice, I think. Jeroen, can you take it from here? Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Floris. I will now give a short live demo on Camunda and Operator Fabric. And I can show how they work together, how we manage to cobble them. First, I will show the business process which we have modeled in Camunda. So you can model your business process in the Camunda modeler, which I can just start. And here is the business process. It's a mock-up business process, so it's not a real one, but it's just to show you what you can do with Camunda in combination with Operator Fabric. In this case, we have modeled a business event where a voltage problem might or might not occur, and the voltage problem enters the system on the left in the small envelope over here. It will go to a decision table where a decision is made whether or not this voltage is within or outside its set boundaries. Well, we log the result, and here the actual decision is being made. Either the measurement is okay and we can just exit the business process and this will fine, and we wait for the next event or measurement to arrive, or we have to alert an operator saying that, well, we have measured this and doesn't look quite okay, so please have a look at it and tell us what to do. And after the operator has made a choice, the answer is fed back into the system, and then this model will exit. Of course, you can make this as complex as you like. You can add more choices, make sure that if the operator makes a choice that it re-enters the business process, and then more based upon his decision, another flow in this process is made, and maybe the operator has to make another decision, or another operator has to make a decision. You can make this as complex as you'd like. In this case, it's a quite straightforward process. We have the business rules more or less in here, which is the decision table. And this is just a simple table which you can have a look in. And you can see, well, it's really simple. It says if the measurement on the swell L1 is greater than 5, then please make sure that this is the output, etc. It's just a mock-up to make sure that the system works as intended and for demonstration purposes. So we now go to Operator Fabric. So let's see. Of course, you have to log in because each operator can see different cards because they all have different permissions. In this case, there is just one event. What I will now do is I will simulate the measurement. And this measurement, I can already say, is going to be outside of its boundaries. So this one should appear on the Operator Fabric dashboard. So let's send the measurement. First we go to Camunda. This is the Camunda cockpit. This is the live view of the business process. So I have to log in. We're using the open source version of Camunda, which is free to download. You can see we have two process definitions. one PROSPA, one integration test, and we're going to look at the top one, because that's the one we just showed. So if you click on it, you can see we have the same business process as we had in the modeler, but in this case we have a small one indicator over here, meaning that there is one business process instance which is now waiting for user input. And this user input is actually waiting for the operator to make an action on his or her card. So if you now go back to the operator window, which we just logged into, we can see we have an operator handling card which has just arrived. And if we click on it, we have some more detailed information. So a small explanation about operator fabric. On the left, you have all the cards, which is now operator handling, and the other one is input needed. And these are the cards, these are the events which require attention of an operator. You can, of course, Floor's already explained, you can filter them, you can sort them, you can do whatever you want with them. The colors indicate the severity of the different cards. And of each card, on the right side hand side, you have the detail window, where you have detailed information about this specific card. So this card, it has an header saying, well, further, please indicate that further action is needed. And if you go below a little bit, you can see we have here a grid overview of part of the grid, in which operator has a look at it. And of course, he can, based on the information presented above, he can say, well, I have to look at this small part of the grid. And he can click on it, and he can then see, for example, again, this is a mockup, the voltages will flow through this specific line. And after the operator has had a really close look at it, he says, well, this does not look okay, further action is required. And he can send the information by clicking the right bottom button, the validate answer. And he said, and the operator fabric responds with, your answer is confirmed, please thank you. As a result, now with his feedback, has been sent back to Camunda. So if we now look at Camunda again, we can indeed see that the number one, which was standing here, the small one indicator, is now gone, meaning this whole process is now finished. It was waiting for the operator to make a decision. The decision has been made, so this process has ended, and maybe another process has now been started up, requiring probably more user input. So if we go back to the operator fabric window again, like this, you can see that the business process has sent the message back to the operator saying, well, this issue has been taken care of. He has a small summary, and the operator can now click the button on the right corner, bottom corner, acknowledgement and close. So if he selects it, the card will disappear and this issue has been taken care of. And the operator can have a look at the next issue, for example, this one. Okay, this of course looks really nice, but the real power of Operator Fabric is that you can really customize per event or per card how it should look like. So on the left hand side you have all the cards. You can say per card to whom it should be sent to, who is allowed to take an action on it, who is only allowed to view it, and such. And on the right hand side you have the detailed information, and which is just an HTML page in which you can really customize how you want to present your data, which is being sent with a card, and which options you would like to present to the operator. I can have a very brief look into this card definition, because we have some time. Let's see, this is a simple card definition. You can see it has an ID, which means, well, it belongs to this process ID. This process ID has several states, state 1, state 2, and per state you can, of course, you can make the card, give the card colors and text and everything, but the most important part is the template over here, which says, well, if you have this card or this process with this state, then please show this template. And the template is just an HTML template with a mustache annotation, in which you can then present data to the operator. If you have a small look at such a template, just a very brief look, you can see it's just pure HTML with some mustache annotations in it, where you can show the card data, you can send all kind of data with the card to this operator fabric, so you can present whatever you'd like, so the operator can have a real good look at all the information present and make a very informed decision. So this is basically operator fabric working with Camunda. As a connection method between operator fabric and Camunda, you can use either REST calls, but here at Alejandro we decided to use a Kafka integration, and this Kafka is now also available for all, for the whole world, because it's now integrated into operator fabric as well. So these are all open source projects. Camunda is an open source project which you can just download. Operator Fabric, which is hosted by RTE France, you can also just download it. And basically what I've just demonstrated, you can try it for yourself if you'd like, for free. So I would say please do this. Check the current code out from GitHub, make modifications, and publish your improvements back to GitHub by pull request, so everybody can contribute and benefit from each other's modifications. Thank you. Links are provided in the current slide, and hopefully we see you next time. Thank you for your attention.
So hi there. Thanks for joining. I do see two questions, so happy to answer those questions. So what other companies are behind Operator Fabric besides Alejandro? Well, currently only one, that's RTE, the French TSO, and together we develop on that. And where can I demo Operator Fabric? We do have some information which I can share already in the chat. We'll do that. So you can find information on GitHub, where you can also download the code, and there's also a getting started guide. So answers that your question. Okay.
Maybe as an additional information, you can also download the Docker images, because they're also hosted on the Docker Hub. So if you look at the Getting Started project, you can see it just downloads the Docker images, so you don't even need to compile it yourself. You can just download images and run them in a Docker environment.
I see that Govert says, hello, Floris. Govert, do you have any questions or... Okay. Well, if there are no further questions, then I would like to thank everyone for attending this session. And I hope you have a good summit. Bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.